What are the best workouts for your DASH or type? How do we know which exercise is best for us? According to Ayurveda, that depends on your DASH or. Ayurveda is the world's oldest health system, originating in India 5,000 years ago. It is based on the concept of bioindividuality. There is no one diet or lifestyle that works for all people, because we are unique. Ayurveda classifies all people, food, and things into three doshas, or energies, or body types. The doshas are vata, air and space energy, pitta, fire and water energy, and kapha, water and earth energy. Ayurveda gives specific recommendations on what type of movement each dosha needs, depending on their physiology and mental characteristics. So what's the best type of exercise for me? The one that pacifies your dosha. Vata type. Vata is the airy dosha. Vata types are quick moving, with cool body temperatures, weak digestive systems, and a tendency toward dryness, leading to gas, bloating, and constipation. Vatas typically have thin bodies, and have a very difficult time putting on muscle or fat. Vatas are naturally attracted to intense cardio classes like cycling and running, but what they need is actually more grounding. Vata type will benefit from slow and steady strength training, TRX bands, dynamic stretching, and anything that improves their balance. Vatas often have creaking, cracking joints that are easily injured, so they have to make sure their form is right. A boot camp might be too quick and intense for them, so they're better off exercising in their own time, really making sure their alignment is on point, so they can build muscle safely. Try lunges, squats, resistance bands, and exercises on a single leg to improve your balance and agility. Pitta type. Pitta is the hot and fiery dosha. They have warm body temperatures, strong digestive systems, and never-ending appetites, which can sometimes lead to acidity. They love a good workout that pushes their bodies to the limit. They are naturally drawn to intense workouts like CrossFit, because they are naturally athletic, with a bit of a competitive streak. However, what they really need is to calm and cool down. Hardcore exercise will actually cause adrenal fatigue and an increase in cortisol, the stress hormone. Even though they love dripping in sweat, they really need the opposite of that. Pittas should strive to practice more yoga, Pilates, and swimming, which build muscle without overtaxing the adrenals. They don't do well in the heat, so hot yoga isn't quite the best for them, as it will lead to burnout. Instead, a slow cooling yin practice is perfect. It's also really important that they meditate after a workout to ground their energy, so they don't take that tension into the rest of their day. Kapha type. Kapha is the earth mama dosha. They are the ones who have to convince themselves to work out, and maybe bribe themselves with a snack afterward. They often resist movement and would much rather hang out on the couch. Kaphas gain weight easily, most easily of the all doshas, and become sluggish, heavy, and lethargic when imbalanced. Kapha types may not exercise at all, but will benefit from it the most. Walking is a good start, especially uphill to get the body moving. Kaphas should strive to sweat every day, because that is the antidote to their imbalance. They should incorporate more high-intensity interval training, HIIT, moves such as jumping jacks and mountain climbers into their workout routine. They do best with quick-moving vinyasa yoga classes, and heated sweaty sessions are highly recommended. Kaphas actually have the highest endurance of all the doshas, and can tolerate the longest duration of exercise. All it takes is getting over the mental hurdle. Regardless of your dosha or type, exercise is one of the most healing things we can do for the mind, body, and spirit. It's important to find the right type of exercise that gives your body what it needs, without over or under doing it.